It's Memorial Day and we're remembering those who have given up their lives for something they believed in. Let's talk about this and more.
Join us on Wake Up with Hope right now. Welcome to the last Monday of May. It's Memorial Day Monday. We would like to take a moment to remember those who gave their lives to defend the country and its values. You know, Memorial Day became a national holiday in 1971, and it is observed every year on the last Monday of May.
Thank you for joining us this morning, friends. We are excited to be here, and we can't wait to spend this time with you.
You know, we have this program for a special reason, to share hope. And not just any hope, but the only true hope that is found in Jesus Christ alone.
Friends, it is because Jesus left heaven and came to this earth that we have any hope at all. And his resurrection leaves us with the blessed hope that one day soon he will come again and take us home with him.
Amen. And of course, we want to share that hope with you on today's program. So let's begin by taking a look back at what took place on this day in history.
At 11:30 a.m. on May 29, 1953, Edmund Hillary of New Zealand and Tenzing Norgay, a Sherpa of Nepal, became the first explorers to reach the summit of Mount Everest, which at 29,035 feet above sea level is the highest point on Earth. The two, part of a British expedition, made their final assault on the summit after spending a fitful night at 27,900 feet. News of their achievement broke around the world on June 2, the day of Queen Elizabeth II's coronation, and Britons hailed it as a good omen for their country's future.
Have you ever set your mind to accomplish something great? Have you accomplished it? You know, it's a good idea to have dreams and goals in life. You know, it gives us something to work towards and helps us to keep motivated to better ourselves. And as Christians, God encourages us to become our best selves. In fact, in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10, it says that we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them.
God created us to do great things, friends. He created us in his image to do good works. And the greatest works we can do and the greatest goal we can have is to become like our Savior, to fulfill his purpose and glorify his name by following in his footsteps. And as we do, we can be sure that God can restore his image in us. Amen. I want that, don't you?
Amen, amen. You know, Gia and Olive are back this morning to share another delicious and healthy recipe, this time for vegan bliss balls.
Say hi!
Hi!
What are we making?
Bliss balls.
We're making bliss balls today, and this is a really simple recipe for lunch boxes or on the go. Something at the supermarket I hate doing is when I go with the kids, I don't take anything with me, and then they're like, can we buy this? Can we buy that? And they just want to eat chips and stuff from the supermarket aisle. But this is so easy to make, and you're going to help us, aren't you? Okay, so what have we got?
Dates.
We've soaked them in water and we've just let them get soft and gooey enough to be able to stick everything together. And what's this?
Cocoa.
Very good. I thought I was going to say chocolate. So there's cocoa and we've got...
Coconut.
Very good. I'm impressed. And this is like the main bulk of it, which is oat bran. Now, if you are gluten intolerant, you can get like a gluten-free oats or use something different, like rice. People can get rice crumbs. You can buy them now in the health food section and you can use rice crumbs instead. Or you can use wheat germ, which I like using wheat germ because it actually bulks it up so nicely and it tastes like a bit of a cake. Now, we are going to process it until it's mixed together really well and sticky. Go. Off. Okay, so we had to add a touch of water because if it's too crummy, you need to add a touch of water until it's sticky enough to roll into a ball. But if it's too wet, you add a little bit more of your oat bran or your wheat germ, whatever you're using for your dry ingredients.
Can I roll some?
You can roll some because we washed our hands ready to roll. So now it looks like this. And we're gonna roll it into little balls, and we've got some coconut here. I've got a clear little container. I'm gonna throw it in the fridge because I always use clear containers so that I know what I've got in my fridge and the kids could see that it's a healthy treat. They can have it straight after a meal. And we'll just throw it into here, little balls, and then we'll mix them around. Can you mix them around?
Uh-huh.
That's it, and can you put them in the container? There you go. So try our bliss balls. We'll see you next time with a new recipe. Say bye.
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 We love music here at Wake Up With Hope, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Yes, it's a beautiful way to worship God and to meditate on His goodness for each one of us. That's why we often share music on our program. And today is one of those programs. Right now, we have music from the Collinsworth family. They will sing Wherever You Are.
No language my rapture can tell. I know that the light of His presence with me doth continually dwell.
Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, how I love to proclaim it, His child and forever.
Redeemer, I think of Him all the day long. I sing, for I cannot be silent. His love is the theme of my song. His love is the theme of my song.
His love is the theme of my song. Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the
enjoying today's program, don't forget to share it with a friend or visit our website at hopetv.org/wakeup to see more. And search for us on YouTube to check out our channel there and keep up with us as well.
We'll be right back with more.
It's time for the Health Connection. Listen in as they share practical health tips for abundant living.
Time for the Health Connection. Your Health Connection. As you opened your eyes from sleep, did you feel rested? Truly rested? How much sleep is enough? 6, 8, 10 hours? Experts say 7 to 8. Others and I empathize with them, say just 5 more minutes as they hit the snooze button. Lack of sleep, real deep restful sleep, is a huge problem, driven by many factors. In fact, it's equal to the national debt, it's so high. What are the factors that cause us sleeplessness? Work, stress, the devices, the screen time. We've become so dependent on those devices, on our cell phones, on our pads, on our computer screens, and we spend so much time, and they actually disturb our sleep architecture. Then, of course, there are substances, including caffeine in that coffee people drink at night, for example. Large and late meals. Strenuous exercise late in the day. A very hot environment. Extraneous light coming in to the room. All of these are factors. So what are the real benefits of adequate sleep so that you awake refreshed? Reduced levels of diabetes, reduced levels of inflammation load, even, and listen up to this, a decreased risk for Alzheimer's. It's been shown that people sleeping poorly have a higher risk for dementia. Of course, those errors and accidents, those too are less when we've slept well. What's better when you sleep well? Your mood, your mental health, your memory, our immune system, our skin, our healing processes, even our weight management improves, heart health, the ability to concentrate and focus, and I know that is something which is so important to each one of us. Our energy and productivity improve the better that we sleep. So what can you do to sleep better? Take smaller, earlier evening meals. Cut screen use at least an hour before bedtime to give your mind the ability to slow down. Darken the room. Reduce light as much as possible. Cool the environment as best you can. And open windows where possible. That's always healthy. Have a gratitude journal. Before you sleep, write down the good things that have happened and those things for which you're grateful and the people for whom you're grateful. Reflect on the promises in God's word and the peace he gives us. And then you'll wake up each day filled with hope.
If you're enjoying our program, share us with a friend and visit us at hopetv.org/wakeup for more.
We'd love to hear from you, friends. Please stop by our official Wake Up With Hope Facebook page and let us know if our program is making a difference in your life. When we return, we will have today's devotional thought from the Voice of Prophecy. Wake Up With Hope. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Wake Up With Hope.
And right now, our friends at Voice of Prophecy join us to share this morning's devotional thought.
How do you feel when you hear about something new? Are you instantly excited about the latest and greatest news or resource or product? Or are you more like me, initially skeptical, but also curious? I think that natural skepticism and curiosity are typical reactions to new information. And some of us take longer to research or to process new things than others of us. We all have different reaction times, don't we? And the first disciples of Jesus, well, they were no different from us today. Their process or reaction times and their styles, they varied too. And yet for each of them, their belief became real when they experienced Jesus. Now, John and Andrew, the first disciples, they immediately followed Jesus and wanted to learn more from him. And after spending some time with Jesus, Andrew told his brother Simon Peter about him. Andrew wanted to tell his brother the good news that Messiah was here. Well, everything that they'd read and heard about from John the Baptist was true. After John and Andrew, Jesus went to Galilee and he found Philip. Now, Jesus invited Philip to follow him. And he did. And just like Andrew shared the news of Jesus with his brother, Philip shared the news with his friend, Nathanael. Now, you might know Nathaniel, Philip's friend, as Bartholomew. Same person, just two different names. So Philip invites his friend to come and see Jesus. So let's read about it in John chapter 1 and verse 45. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him of whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." And Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Now, Philip and Nathanael weren't unfamiliar with Jesus. Just a few days before the conversation that we just read, John the Baptist had declared to his followers that Jesus was the Lamb of God. Philip and Nathanael were likely in the group of followers. What did they think of John's announcement? Well, it seems that Philip processed the news quickly. When Jesus found him in Galilee a few days later, Philip followed Jesus. But Nathanael was clearly still processing. Did you catch the skepticism in Nathanael's reply to his friend? Can anything good come out of Nazareth? He wasn't so sure just yet if Jesus was Messiah, the one they had all waited for, the one the prophets spoke of. Nathanael didn't believe that Jesus wasn't Messiah. He just needed some time to study and to pray. And before Philip found him, he was doing just that. He was sitting under a fig tree praying. Was this man who John the Baptist declared to be the Lamb of God truly Messiah? Well, as Nathanael prayed, he might have asked God to show him a sign, to send him proof that Jesus was Messiah. Have you ever prayed a prayer like that, asking God to show you definitively if something was right or true or not? I have, and God always comes through for me. Well, Philip encouraged his friend to walk with him to find Jesus. And as they walked, they saw him. So let's continue the account from the book of John. We'll pick up John 1, verse 47. Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him and said of him, "Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom is no deceit." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered and said to him, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you." Nathanael answered and said to him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered and said to him, "Because I said to you, I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? You will see greater things than this." What an encounter! Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, and he didn't just see the man as others did. Jesus saw Nathanael's heart and that he was wrestling with his belief in him. And so Jesus announced Nathanael in the way that he saw him, a true Israelite, meaning one who followed God's ways, a man in whom there is no deceit or guile, as some translations put it. Jesus saw Nathanael as a man after his own heart. There were no false pretenses or hypocrisy in Nathanael's faith. And reflecting his transparent and honest personality, Nathanael asked Jesus, "How do you know me?" Well, Jesus told Nathanael about seeing him under the fig tree. And in that moment, Nathanael experienced Christ's divinity. He saw on Jesus' face the answer to those prayers. Here in the person of Jesus was the sign that he prayed for. And Nathanael's response, "It's lovely. I can almost see the joy gushing out with the words." "Teacher," he begins, and then he continues, "you are the Son of God." In experiencing Jesus' divinity, Nathanael declares his belief more strongly than even John, Andrew, or Philip before him had. His curiosity satisfied, he is all in and ready to follow Jesus. And Jesus seemed pleased with this naturally exuberant response. I imagine him gently laughing as he tells Nathanael, "You believe because I said I saw you under the fig tree?" Oh, this was just the first of many miraculous and divine things that Nathanael and the other disciples would witness. It was the beginning of an incredible faith journey. Now, in the phase of wonderful news, Messiah is here. Nathanael prayed, and when he experienced Christ's divinity, he believed. Our own faith journey, it can be similar. Perhaps you're listening to this message right now, and you're skeptical. Who is this Jesus, really? Could he truly see this man under a fig tree so long ago? And this man gave up everything to follow him? Well, if you're curious, I invite you to feed your curiosity. This account with Nathanael, Philip, and Jesus, it's from the book of John, chapter 1. The Gospel of John is a wonderful place to begin reading if you've never read the scriptures before. And talk to God. Tell him your questions, your worries, even your skepticism. He can handle all of it. And like Nathanael, our curiosity and then our faith is verified as we experience Christ. I invite you, come and see him. Hope Channel family, let's pray together. Lord, thank you for seeing us as we truly are and not as others see us. Lord, some listening today have questions about you, but they're honest questions that come from the heart. Father, others may see a cold exterior or a stubborn heart, but Lord, you see that each person processes their faith in their own way. Thank you for sending Jesus, and thank you for your love. Amen. Nathanael believed that Jesus was Messiah when he told him that he saw him under the fig tree. Talking to Jesus and experiencing his divinity convinced Nathanael our faith can grow just the same way. Well, thank you for joining us this Monday morning. May God go with you this week, and may it be filled with hope and peace in him.
Thank you so much for those encouraging words.
And friends, thank you so much for being with us here today and watching Wake Up With Hope.
Please join us tomorrow as Jesus 101 will be with us to share a morning devotional. We will have a dedicated prayer session and so much more. And if you enjoyed today's messages and would like to learn more about the Bible, visit hope.study to receive your free Bible study guides.
You know, our free Bible study guides are sure to be a life-changing experience. Again, that's hope.study. And before we go, we have a Bible promise to share just for you. Today's Bible promise is found in Matthew chapter 7, verses 9 to 11. And the Bible says, "Which of you, if your son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a snake? If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him?"
Amen. Friend, have you ever felt like God isn't answering your prayers? Don't give up. Keep pressing your petitions to the throne of grace. Even though God may not answer your prayer right away, he is listening, and he will answer it in the best way and at the perfect time. God is too wise to make a mistake. So trust your needs into the hands of the one who seeks our best and eternal good.
Let's pray together. Our Father in heaven, today we're so humbled and thankful that we can look up towards heaven and know that there's a God who cares about me, about us, individually and very intimately. And today, Lord, we choose to put our trust in you. You know the end from the beginning. You know which direction we ought to go with our day, with our life. And so, Lord, guide us. We thank you for the hope that you give us continuously as we continue to look up to you. Thank you, Lord, for answering our prayers. In Jesus' name, amen.